Hey, brothers and sisters, this is your favorite brother from another mother coming to you live from North Carolina. I hope you guys are all doing all right tonight. Praise the living God. As I mentioned in the last video at the beginning, I had an open vision this afternoon of 444. Still connecting to the dreams that I've had and still praying for the Lord for complete understanding and wisdom. And the Lord has told me he would give it to me. So I'm just waiting on him for that. All connected to the rapture, start of the tribulation, the four blood moons, and all that. Still connected to the same time frame that people are hearing and talking about this fall, September. Anyway, brothers and sisters, not setting any dates because I haven't heard. I haven't heard clearly from the Lord on that. I'm just getting the peripheral here. I'm looking through a glass darkly, waiting on the Lord to connect it with my brothers and sisters. As the Bible says, there's wisdom in a multitude of counsel, and that we all are looking for through a glass darkly, so we see a little bit each. So that's what I want to talk to you about in this video, about twilight. I've been talking about that, the stand to, prepared for that suddenness of attack just before, just at dawn or just at dusk. So here we are, brothers and sisters, in the twilight zone. In the twilight time, as the Lord has been talking to me about today I went out and I go to this park area, wooded area, and I have a video to make about that too. Illuminati history in North Carolina, the people that owned that land, not the original owners, but the owners of that land were the Reynolds family. You know R.J. Reynolds? Illuminati family. As in Camel cigarettes. This place is called the Camel City. It's the nickname. And I need to make a video about the Lord was speaking to me about that today while I was out there. And then I was realizing, hey, I'm on their land. It was their land. Now it's a park. The Illuminati history of North Carolina and the Reynolds family. I'm going to be back with a video about that. It's pretty interesting. I knew all these facts from my relatives in history who worked for their making these cigarettes and all that stuff, Winston's and Salem's and Camel's and all that, but I never connected them all together. The Lord supernaturally connected them in my mind this afternoon. That's awesome. I'll be back. It's a little taste there. But anyhow, in this video, I want to talk to you about, I was out there, it's about 5 p.m., and it was getting ready to thunderstorm, and I had to hurry up and get out of there. But it got darker and darker and darker, and I was already in the woods. And then the Lord began to speak to me about the Illuminati history of that family. And secondly, about the twilight zone and the twilight time that we're living in. Twilight is, as I said, is the moment that's just when the sun has set until it's 6 degrees below the horizon, it becomes dusk in the evening. And in the morning, the first light, before the sun actually breaks the horizon, 6 degrees below the horizon until it breaks the horizon, which we call dawn, dusk and dawn. But there's a period before and after the sun rises and sets that's called twilight. And so like the old TV show, The Twilight Zone, we, brothers and sisters, are now, as the Lord has been telling me for weeks now, and I've been making videos about it, we are in the twilight zone. I guess I need to put the theme music on there. It's probably copyrighted. We are in that twilight zone. And so, I talked before about how, you know, you got Bruce Jenner and all of this twisting of reality, like in the show, The Twilight Zone, all this bizarre, wacky, you know, evil is good and good is evil, as the Bible says. You know, they'll call good evil and evil good. And that's happening. All those Bible prophecies are coming to pass, and it's getting more and more bizarre world, as they say. The weather, earthquakes, whatever, wars, rumors of wars, all the things that the Bible talks about. Those birth pains are already here. And I could summarize those again and again and again. Most of you are watching this, you already know it. But what the Lord talked to me about was not those things. You know, because the Lord talked to me about how to practically apply this in a wisdom that I didn't think about. So that's why God is awesome, brothers and sisters. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, my Redeemer. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. I can feel the Holy Spirit. Of course, He's moving. And the Lord was moving today when he was talking to me about this. Praise his holy name, because that's what the Lord wants me to, ultimately what the Lord wants you to experience is him. Right now, I speak right now in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Hallelujah. And I speak the move of the revival of the Spirit of the living God upon your people, Lord. Father, I ask, believe, and prophesy. And speak by the authority of the Most High God, the living God, the creator of heaven and earth. Hallelujah. I speak that the Spirit of the living God will move upon his people. Even as the Lord said, I'll shake this place. Not only the earth, but the heaven and the earth will I shake. Hallelujah, says the Lord. Before the great and terrible day of the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God in the highest. Peace on earth and goodwill toward all men. Hallelujah. For our Lord and our God, hallelujah, has manifested himself in the flesh. He was born of a woman. Hallelujah. Seen of angels. Hallelujah. Taken up in glory. Hallelujah. Great is the mystery of godliness. Blessed be the name of our Lord and our God. Hallelujah. And his Christ. Hallelujah. Who he gave as a ransom for us. Hallelujah. For the blood of the Lamb, Yeshua HaMashiach, has cleansed me of all unrighteousness. He has causeth me to triumph in all things. Hallelujah. Through the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. He causes us to always triumph. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? Hallelujah. For it's been swallowed up in victory. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord God Most High, creator of heaven and earth. Hallelujah. Hallowed be thy name, Lord. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in this place as it is in heaven. Hallelujah. 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 Sanctify thyself. Sanctify thyself, church. Prepare to meet the Lord thy God. Hallelujah. 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 Blessed be his name. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. As the Lord give me that word for you. I knew he had a word. By the grace of God, I have more of a word. But I want to talk to you about what the Lord was telling me about the twilight. What I gave you is the good news. The Lord wants you to be exhorted. The Lord wants you to be exhorted to be full of joy in the Holy Ghost. As it says, righteousness and joy in the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. But brothers and sisters, when it's twilight time, this is for the world really. When it's twilight time, it's hard to see. See, it becomes kind of dark, brothers and sisters. When it's twilight time, it's kind of dark. It's hard to see, you know. The light is dim. So that's why in the last video I just talked about recognizing the devil, recognizing the enemy, recognizing wickedness. The darker it is as twilight progresses toward dusk, it becomes much more difficult to see, brothers and sisters. That's why we only have one lamp to see when it's almost dark. For the Lord declared in his word, thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. So the only light that we have, because the twilight light is getting so weak, especially when you're in the, brothers and sisters, when you go in the woods, you know, you're surrounded by hard-hearted trees. You know, you're surrounded not by trees of righteousness. You're surrounded by, you know, you're in thick darkness. You know, even though there's a little bit of twilight, you know, the day is far gone. You know, the summer is over and the day is far gone. The night, you know, the day is spent and summer is spent and we are not saved, says in Isaiah. Talking about the nation of Israel. That's where we are, brothers and sisters. We're in that thick darkness. We're in the deep woods surrounded by not trees of righteousness, because trees of righteousness are planted by the river of living water. But these trees are out in the other areas, you know, in the dense darkness. And you get out there, it's easy to get lost. You can't see good. There's not much light. There's snakes in the woods. There's all kinds of animals that are not necessarily friendly. Foxes in this place. There are fox out there in this place running around. I've seen them before. Red foxes, as a matter of fact, and not Fred Sanford, the red fox, but real red foxes. And they're out there, brothers and sisters. All these creatures. You know, even like deer. I mean, deer seems like an innocent animal, but it's still a beast. Still a beast. But it looks like, hey. Anyway, brothers and sisters, the only light for us. There's only light for us is thy word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. So the word of God is all we have, brothers and sisters, in this dark hour. You know, there's two groups. I always end up talking to two groups. There's the group that is spooky spiritual, basically out of what we call the charismatic movement. I'm sure I mentioned this in a video in the past, but I don't think lately. I was talking to somebody lately about on the phone. Our brother, we were talking about on the phone, but I think it was Brother Luke I was talking to on the phone about it, maybe. The other day. Anyhow, I ask you guys to pray for Brother Luke, for a hundredfold blessing on Brother Luke. Brother Luke needs to be blessed, and I ask you guys to pray and agree with me for Brother Luke to be blessed in Jesus' name. Anyhow, the charismatic movement, brothers and sisters, is basically this. And lots of denominations that are not Pentecostal denominations, some people started receiving the baptism of the Holy Spirit, especially like in the late 60s, early 70s, 67 through mid 70s, what they call a charismatic movement. And what those denominations did, because they didn't want to lose members, they started letting them have their own thing. So you have charismatic groups who meet in almost all of the denominations, but the thing is they don't have the word teaching that goes with that. A lot of the churches say, well, just let them have their own thing. You know, this is a charismatic group. They meet, have their own thing. Unlike if you went to a church of God or Assemblies of God or a Pentecostal church, Pentecostal holiness and all this kind of stuff, where they're teaching that. And then they have the pastors and the whole church is involved. And then their bottom line is they're looking at doctrine. So if someone gets up and says some wacky stuff, they say it's a prophecy from God. If you're in a Assemblies of God church, then the elders, as the Bible says, that let some people prophesy one at a time and let the elders judge whether it be from God or not. So when you go to a full gospel church, that's the right expression, a full gospel church, meaning they teach the full gospel, not just part of the gospel, but the full gospel, including people being healed and signs and wonders following people believing, all that. That's part of the gospel. Jesus said, these signs shall follow those who believe. In my name, they'll cast out demons. They'll lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. They'll speak with new tongues. These signs are to follow the believer. Mark chapter 16. And so anyhow, if you were in a Assemblies of God or a Church of God or whatever, a full gospel church, and you gave a word, then the pastor would say, hey, That is against the word of God. That is not from God. And the elders of the church, usually it's the pastor, but it could be some of the elders, they will take you aside and say, wait a minute, you know, what you said is against the word of God. Talk to you about it, counsel you about it, pray with you and see what's going on. And when you get to a charismatic group, say a home Bible study, there's a charismatic group, you don't have any elders there. And when people start talking all these wacky doctrines, it's not in the Bible, we'll see then there's no balance there. There's no correction. There's no accountability in a lot of these type of groups. That's where our cults come from and all that, you know, come out of those kind of things. Someone with a special revelation from God and no one there to correct them, or they won't receive correction. If you go to church and you won't receive correction, then they'll say, okay, well, you can't be a member here anymore. Or whatever, they go through a process that you'll be, you know, whatever you want to call it. As Paul said, we turn people over to the enemy. That their spirit might be saved in 1 Corinthians. So anyhow, there's a church discipline. Sometimes it needs to be done. By the grace of God, let it be rare, but sometimes it's needed. So that's why, brothers and sisters, what I'm trying to tell you. All the people that get been out nervous and upset with something they saw on YouTube. I mean, I know, you know, you can't ever, you know, that's what God put me on here for. By the grace of God, you can ask me. I'm not saying that. I want to answer you and help you and help the church. I make videos about it, help the church. It's my job. It's my work for the Lord. But if the word of God is a lamp unto your feet and a light unto your path, you know, you won't be easily deceived. I mean, it's, you know, we can still be deceived. Don't, you know, like I told the story about myself in the last video. I was almost deceived, but the Lord didn't allow me to. If it wasn't for the Lord, I would have been. But the Lord made a way that I was not deceived by this church. But it can happen to anybody. But that's the grace of God and the Word. We need the Word. And we need the Spirit. And we need wise counsel. As I said, there's wisdom in the multitude of counsel, the Bible says. I'm thinking of two different things at one time. But anyway, brothers and sisters, so we need elders to deal with, to talk to. And I thank the Lord, you guys, I have people every day asking me questions about these kind of things. And that's what I'm here for. But I just say this, it's not good for you to get upset about it. Now, if you hear something, it's bothering you and you message me, that's not what I mean. I'm talking about getting off the deep end about it. I've had people up all night and couldn't sleep because somebody made a video saying if you didn't speak in tongues, you couldn't be raptured. And you know, they were up all night about it. Now, when you hear a new doctor and you're not sure about it, it shouldn't, you know, you should inquire about it and pray about it and ask me or, you know, elders and pastors about it. But don't let it move you until you find out, you know. That's what I pray, that you won't be moved, you know, other than what the Word of God says. That you'd be filled with His peace, you know. You need His peace, and that's what the Lord wants you to have, His peace. So, any brothers and sisters, I want to do some preaching and ministering to you, which I did kind of in the beginning of this video. Praise God. That's what I love to do, but it seems like the Lord has had me on a teaching bent since I've been back in the States this time. So I will continue to do that by His grace. I'll be back with a third video.